Well, good evening, friends. Welcome to Chapelwood. We are so glad that you're here tonight for our gospel sing. I hope you have your dial set on fun, because we're going to have a lot of fun and sing some great songs. So thank you so much for being here. I did want to let you know that we are going to take up an offering during the program tonight. And so if you would like to make a gift to the church or to this music ministry, we would appreciate that so much. We would just be so grateful to you for that. And before we begin, let's have a word of prayer. Gracious and loving God, thank you so much for this time, and we come to sing and to celebrate your love, your goodness, your mercy, and your grace. Thank you for each person who is here. Thank you for all of the gifts and talents and passions that they offer to us this evening, and may this place be filled with the love of your Spirit. In Christ's name we pray all of these things. Amen.
Welcome, Houston. I heard y'all are so ready just to sing, aren't you? I could hear y'all, and it's coming in just a minute. You're going to get to sing with us all night. Welcome to Chapelwood United Methodist. My name is Cameron Cody. I have the wonderful honor of being the director of music of this great church, and I get to serve alongside James Kelly each week. How many of you see us online? Yes, if you don't follow us, we play dueling pianos on Facebook on Cameron Cody Music each week.
Yes, we do.
We'd love for you to join us. This next song, James, tell us about it.
Oh, this is an old gospel song called Mansion Over the Hilltop. And if you love old gospel music, then you're going to have a great time tonight because pretty much everything here is gospel songs. This is an old one called Mansion Over the Hilltop. Let's do it.
If you can hear it, because you've got inner ear in, but they sound fabulous.
I can hear it. They'll sound amazing.
And we're just getting warmed up. There is an unseen hand to me. You know, I think we've got a quartet back there in the back. I'm gonna bring them on out. That leads me through ways.
Y'all welcome these singers right here.
I cannot see while going through all this world of old. Y'all, his hand, it still leads. Oh, where I go. Choir, y'all stand. Here we go. Listen to this, Mark. And while it still leads, I have no fear. I know to lead. Hold me to that hope where sin and no more sorrow. There can come. Let's sing it. Here we go. Gentlemen, we're going to add a little bit more to this group up here, and I want to see. I want y'all to know that if we could get a bus, we'd take you all on the road with us for sure. Will y'all put your hands together for Mr. Mark Lowry and Tiffany Coburn?
Thank you. How have y'all been? It's so good to be together in the middle of a plague. Can we turn the house lights up? Would you mind? Yeah, because I like to see the people. You know, look at you people. You came out. Thank you. Any Baptists here? I always check. Oh, yeah. Ah, they're my people. My people always show up. Any Methodists? Woo! Well, Lord, I hope so. It's your church. Any Catholics? Woo! Yeah. An excited Catholic. God bless you. Thank you for coming. Tell Mary I said hello, would you? I'm Baptist. We're not allowed to talk to her. But tell her I said thanks for that song. But anyway, we're so happy you're here. We were here last year in the middle of the plague, and when I heard Cameron was going to do this again, I said, not without me, you're not. And I love this church. I heard your preacher preach this morning on the web. And I want to tell you, he's good. He knows his stuff. I enjoyed that sermon. I thought, surely he's Baptist. But then I heard he had a Baptist brother, so that made it good. Anybody just get saved, you don't know what you are yet, lift your hand. Don't lift your hand. A Baptist will sign you up. We are good. In fact, a sweet lady brought me a picture tonight of H. Frank Ford. You know, my grandfather was led to the Lord by a preacher knocking on his door back in the 40s, and he was a pastor of the church right down the street. Papa got saved, Nanny got saved, we joined that church. I didn't, I wasn't born yet. But my mama met Daddy in that church. I mean, we are Houstonians. And then they got married in that church, and then they started having babies near that church. And I was born in that church, and we had a choir like this choir. I love choirs. And Mama played the piano Sunday morning, Sunday night, and Wednesday night. And I'd be up in the back row of the shelf. I called it the shelf. It was really a balcony. And I'd be up there with my friends cutting up and having a good time until Mama saw me. She'd be singing, oh, victory. And she'd be loving God, having a good time until she spotted me in the balcony. I was raised in that church until one Sunday morning. Brother H. Frank Ford had a stroke in the pulpit, and he passed away. He's the only preacher we ever knew. So we had to go find a new one. And Daddy was in charge. I was six. Daddy was a deacon, and he was on the committee. And they hired this young whippersnapper fresh out of cemetery. And he was doing good at first. He was doing real good, they tell me, until he swerved off into heresy. He started preaching we were going to have to go through the Great Tribulation. That's it. Well, my daddy didn't want to go through the Great Tribulation. So we crossed the street and joined a Baptist church that was going in the rapture. And I always felt sorry for the people at the old church having to go through the Great Tribulation when they could have walked across the street. That's all I have to say for right now.
I want y'all to welcome tonight Miss Tiffany Coburn.
Yes!
Y'all welcome Tiffany.
Everybody.
All the way from sunny Florida. Tiffany has been just a dear friend of mine, but if you've ever been to Epcot, you likely heard her with the Voices of Liberty in the Rotunda, and also Voctiv.
Voctiv, mm-hmm,
the new group Voctiv. If you haven't heard them, they will just bless your soul. They're amazing.
Yeah, are you going to play a game or something? Are you bored? It's my time to do something, and you're going to play a game. Is it that Wordle thing? You're doing that Wordle?
No,
I don't even know what that is.
I just want to know where we're going next.
Oh. Well, all right.
Well, I want y'all
There's a long hair here, right here, but is that can't be yours.
It's mine.
Let's look. Let's look at it. You want it back?
I had one growing out of the center of my nose. That every now and when the sun would hit it, I'd see it and I'd go hunting it. I was on stage with a vocal band one night. Michael English reached over and plucked that thing out of the middle of my nose.
That is a good friend. That's a friend. Yeah.
Tribulation.
Sorry. Is that too much? Okay.
No.
I'll be gone tonight.
I want y'all to hear Tiffany sing.
Uh-oh.
And this next song is called Farther Along.
That's a good one.
Take it away, Ellen.
It's gonna be a good day. Someday.
All right, we're going to teach y'all the song tonight.
Okay.
How many of y'all know the great song Yahweh? Oh, well, you're in for a treat. We're going to teach it to you right now. Brian, take it away. We got the choir back there. Y'all welcome the Chapelwood Choir tonight.
Thank you.
good, y'all. You know, when I was here last year, I could honestly say I'd never seen a healing. But in a year, we've had a follicle healing over here, y'all. Brother, hair has grown out of the pastures. I can no longer say I've never seen a healing. Look at that.
Bald last year, fool.
I know. I'll tell you one thing. You had a little, you had shrubbery up there last year.
The higher the hair, the closer to Jesus.
That's right. If I ever lose my hair, I'm getting a wig too. This head's way too big to be bald. No, I look like Uncle Fester.
Y'all pray the glue holds out.
Well, I'm sweating.
I know, I'm hot too.
I'm going to take my coat off.
Go right ahead.
But the problem is, over the
COVID. A little music, please.
Over the COVID, I grew man boobs, and I didn't mean to. So now they just, that's why I have a coat on. So.
The minute you walked in the joint,
I could tell you were. Woo, it's hot up here.
Okay, we're getting on a slippery slope here.
Oh, it ain't that slippery.
All right. Y'all know this one. Mark's going to lead us on the verses.
All right.
Here we go.
I once was lost in sin, but Jesus took me in. And then a light from heaven filled my soul. Sing, y'all. It bathed my heart in love and wrote my name above. And just a little talk with Jesus makes me whole.
Now let us have
tears, but Jesus is a friend who watches day and night. I go to him in prayer, he knows my every care, and just a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
Now I want to hear y'all do these notes.
Now
Mr. Johnny Salvinson a hand over there on bass for us. Well, I tell you, one of the great honors in my life is being able to tour around this great country with James Kelly. And we have such a good time. He is such a fine musician and man of God. And so I want you to listen as James sings this. It's a new song, but it sounds so gospel.
It sounds like an old gospel song. It's called All My Hope.
I've been held by the Savior. I felt fire from above. And I've been down to the river. And I ain't the same, a prodigal return.
Let's sing it. All my life won shackles and chains, but I've been free and forgiven, and I'm not going back, 'cause I'll never be. Breaks a man, break him down into his knees. God, I've been broken more than a time or two, yes, Lord, but he picked me up and showed me what it means to be a man.
Introduce to you some of these folks who are up here with us tonight. Over on bass, we have Mr. Johnny Salvinson. You've already welcomed him tonight. Next to him is Mr. Chaz Corder. Next to him in our quartet is Mr. Evan Cooper. And if you've followed Chapelwood or my show for a while, this next guy's no stranger. Holding down those high tenor notes, Mr. Cody Arthur. Oh, no. On the drums, we have Gus. And I'll let you introduce the rest of the band.
This electric guitar player right here is Austin. On the bass over here, Marshall. Did you already introduce Dan? Did you say Dan already?
I did not.
Okay, right here on the B3, give it up for Dan Finn. And, of course, our fiddle player, Ellen Story.
She's really why we're all here. And then last but not least, holding down keys when we're standing up singing all the way from Nashville, Mr. Brian Eads. I'll tell you, our last two albums have been produced by Mr. David Clydesdale, a dear friend of ours. And Brian produced our last album with David, and we traveled to Prague to record it, and we just became great friends, and now here we are. So glad to have him tonight. This next song we're going to do, I want y'all to really sing out. We're all going to sing this one together. It's called The Lily of the Valley.
Of 10,000.
sorrow, he's my comfort. In trouble, he's my stay. He tells me every care on him to roam. He's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul.
Mark's going to sing this next one, called Just a Closer Walk with Him. Here we go.
You forgot my voice is dropping.
Just a closer walk with thee.
Sing with me, y'all. Grant it, Jesus.
Grant it, Jesus, is my plea.
Sing with me.
Daily walking close to just a closer walk with thee.
That's the chorus. There you go.
Grant it, Jesus. Grant it, Jesus, is my plea.
Come on, y'all. Sit up straight and sing.
Blessed assurance, oh Jesus, is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory in its soul divine. Hereof salvation, oh, purchased of God, more of his spirit were washed in Jesus' blood. Here we go. Hear that Hammond B3 now. Thank you. I want to do something real quick. Just the piano and the voices.
This is my story.
You know, I tell you one thing about Chapelwood is we're blessed to hear all kind of music at this church. James leads our contemporary service, and then he comes over and does the traditional. But y'all, we got to keep these hymns alive. That's what we're doing right here. There's nothing wrong with that other stuff, the contemporary stuff at all. I'm serious.
Thank you, thank you.
Now, when James leaves, we'll have a different story. No, I love it very much, and they do it so well. But the deep scripture and words, some of these great hymns are sermons in themselves.
Well, you know, they're from great tragedies, so many of them. Very, very epic loss sometimes, and there's a lot of foundational messages in these songs that we can all walk away from with awesome, awesome messages that still apply today, you know?
You know, I know there's a lot of glamour and things to performing, but what I hope you'll walk away here tonight with is...
I was just guessing. I didn't
so
know.
Much for being serious. I want to go back to the hair comment and let you know that out of the four of us up here that are leading, I'm the youngest. James even has me beat. And then it's Tiffany, and then it's Mark, and I'm at the end of the
He's
train.
He's only 30, right?
It's just
30 years old.
30.
You're just a pup. You're just a pup.
But what I want you to know is I want you to leave here with these songs in your heart. And I want you to pass it forward to three other people. Tell somebody about these hymns and ask them to tell three people about how much these great hymns mean to them. And let's keep them alive. There's no reason we can't have all styles of music and do it well. And so we're going to go completely old-fashioned at this moment with just piano, and we're going to crank up the pipe organ, and Tiffany is going to sing It Is Well With My Soul. So will y'all stand as we all sing?
We can all sing together, right? And you know, this was one of those songs that was birthed out of an extreme tragedy. And I don't know it all. I don't know the story by heart to tell everybody, but it's a powerful one. And it was just how this sweet husband kept going after he lost his entire family. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me. Beautiful. Thank you, Jesus.
What's next? He wanted me to tell y'all Dottie Rambo's story before we sing Sheltered in the Arms of God, and I don't have one, so I'm going to tell you a Vestal Goodman story instead. I knew both of them, and both of them, I went over to Dottie's house a lot, and I went over to Vestal. She even cooked a coconut cake for me once, which was her specialty, and now that she's gone, I'll let y'all know it was very dry. I would never have let her know that, but now she knows how to moisturize cake. But anyway, Vestal Goodman was always trying to get me to speak in tongues, and so was Dottie, and I told them I'm still learning English. And Vestal had such a powerful faith, and she prayed for people, and they got healed. I met them at our concerts. They'd come up and say, 30 years ago, Vestal prayed for me, and I'm still here. And I tried that too. I really have. I prayed for people a lot in my life. I've never seen one of them get healed. A couple have died. Anybody want to go home tonight? Form a line. I'll pray for you. But I got good news, you know. I was reading that Bible one day about old Thomas and how he never saw it. Well, he finally did get to see, remember? Thomas was called the Doubting Thomas only because he skipped church on Sunday. Jesus was killed on Friday, and Jesus showed up in church on Sunday, and Thomas slept in. So they called him the Doubting Thomas. Lest I stick my fingers in the holes of his hands, I'm not going to believe. And what I love about Jesus, he told Thomas, go ahead. He just told Mary, don't touch me, I haven't ascended to my Father. But he told Thomas, go ahead, I'll break the rules to get you home. I'm telling you, God is crazy about y'all. He will do everything he can to get you home. And Dottie wrote it well. We are sheltered in the arms of God.
I feel the touch of hands so kind and tender.
They're leading me.
They're leading me in paths that I must drive. I have beside me,
sing y'all.
For I'm sheltered in the arms of God.
So let
the storms rage high, the dark clouds pass,
going to take us right into another one of Dottie's great songs called I've Never Been This Homesick Before. Sing it, James.
There's a light in the window, the table spread in splendor, someone standing by open door. I can see a crystal river I'll spread my wings for flying. Lord, I've never been this homesick before.
Here we go.
See the bright light shine. It's just about home time. I can see my father standing at the door.
Absolute favorite. The words say the tempest may sweep or the wild stormy deep. In Jesus, I'm safe evermore. James, sing it for us.
My soul in sad exile was out on life's sea. So burdened with sin and distressed, I heard a sweet voice saying, make me your choice, and I entered
together. We're going to skip over to I'd Rather Have Jesus, and Tiffany's going to talk a little bit about this and then lead
what
us.
He did there. He just popped it right out. He did that, so I wouldn't be nervous.
We could stay here till midnight, you know.
My goodness. Are you having a good time tonight? I mean, I hope you can see we're having a good time, too. Some songs we know, some parts, and some we're just kind of... You'd be surprised what you hear up here. I'm just kidding. Oh, man. Well, I mean, I grew up with hymns and Gaither songs. Lots of Gaither songs. You know him, right? Yeah, okay. I became a Christian when I was 8 years old. I met Jesus when I was 8 years old, and I did understand it. I did. I had a really wonderful grandmother who loved Jesus, and she herself had a really powerful conversion when she was a young mom. And so she definitely wanted all of her children and her grandchildren to know who Jesus was. And you know, after accepting Jesus into my heart, I just lived for him the best way that I knew how. I didn't have any big story to tell. I mean, I don't. I don't have any big, you know, prodigal son story to tell. But what I do have, and what I had, was a praying grandmother. I had a grandma who knew Jesus. And because of that, she taught me the importance of Scripture. She taught me the importance of Scripture and how we're to hide it in our hearts, right? We're supposed to hide it in our hearts. And I will be honest, the Scriptures that I learned at my grandmother's knee, I probably know those better than those that I've learned as an older person, because I'll be honest, you know, things, they come in and then they go up here when I go to sleep at night. They just kind of fall out. But as I was thinking of what to say, I don't know. The Lord just put this passage on my heart, and I hope it's okay to say it, but it talks a lot about who Jesus is to us. The Lord is my shepherd. Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. As we get older, our friends kind of fall away, those who we shouldn't probably be around. We're doing things differently on a Friday night now than we used to. And what are we doing? Well, I'm trying to fall madly in love with the one who is madly in love with me, and that's my Jesus. I'm trying to learn about him, because we're going to spend eternity with him. So I challenge you tonight, if you don't have a time where you just get alone with the Lord, carve that out of your day. I promise it'll be worth it. Because in the end, he's all we need. Amen? Yeah. I'd rather have Jesus than silver or gold. I'd rather be his than have riches untold. I'd rather have Jesus than houses or lands. I'd rather be led by his nail-pierced hand than to be I'd rather have Jesus
Well, we're not far from the end of our journey tonight, but we've got a couple more. This next one we couldn't not sing. So will you stand as we all sing How Great Thou Art? We're going to sing this just as traditional as we can. So I'll give the intro from the organ, and then y'all come right in. This next one we're going to keep right on going, but while they're doing that, y'all have a seat. We got to take up the money. Oh. They won't let me come back to work tomorrow if we don't take up the money. So while we're doing that, we're going to wrap it up in just a moment, but let's sing while they're doing that. Love Lifted Me. Here we go. I was singing.
Love lifted me.
Mark's going to lead us through now before we start to wrap up our program. This next song, there's something about that name.
Here we go. Jesus, 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 Jesus. There's just something about that name. Master, Savior, Master, Savior, Jesus, like the fragrant
yourselves a big round of applause. If y'all will sing that good and bring two friends, we'll do this again next year. We've got three songs left, and I bet you can almost pick out which three they are. But this next one is called The King Is Coming.
Oh, yes.
The builders' tools are silent. No more time to harvest wheat. Busy housewives cease their labors in the courtroom. No debate. Work on earth has been suspended as the king comes through.
Have a king is coming. The king is coming. I just heard the trumpet sounding, and now his face I see. The king is coming. The king is coming. Lives have been redeemed.
broken homes that he has mended, those from prison he set free.
Little children,
done, everybody. Did you want your pastor to come up and say a word?
He's gone rogue.
Uh-oh. I just...
I've got an order of service, and I don't know where he is right now.
Yeah, I know.
I was supposed to come up after this
song. I think
the
glue might have been inside. Like, the glue might have done something to
The glue sank in. Hey.
You missed that one.
They
that
say, my, I said when the Holy glue, Spirit's working, it doesn't matter.
You want me to get out of the way, is what
yes.
you're saying.
All right, I got it.
Oh boy.
Y'all don't want to miss this song, and when she starts to sing it, you'll know why. Come up after this one.
Oh my goodness. Oh, I want to say a God bless you and a just a hi to my precious friends Walt and Paula Stratton that are here. They're like a second mom and dad to me, and I wanted to say hi earlier, but thank you guys for coming. And hello to my sweet friend who's in the hospital. Peter Gates, I'm praying for you. God is going to heal you. Thank you all for being here tonight. This was a blessing to us, as I hope that you have been blessed tonight and that you will walk away with something special. Yeah. Yeah. the sky shall unfold, preparing his entrance, the storm.
Oh, we shall be Holy Spirit, can I come up now? Tiffany and Mark, thank you. Thanks to our great band. You know, sometimes they say, I'm John Stevens, I'm the pastor here at Chapelwood. You know, we talk about, well, we need more youth in the church. If you look up here on the stage at the players and the singers and the band and the choir, we've got the next generation of music. And what I love about Chapelwood is, as Cam said, there's such a variety of different types of music that we celebrate our Lord and Savior with, and that's just wonderful. Mark, you haven't lost your touch yet, buddy. You still got it. And Tiffany, thank you for being here and blessing us today. Since Mark said my sermon was good this morning, I thought I'd just preach it for you right now. Is that okay? No, I'm not going to do that. But I will say this as we close and end. Thank you all for coming. Tell people about what's going on here and follow. If you don't know Cameron Cody Music on Facebook and social media, also James Kelly has a music page. Mark Lowry has a music page and does stuff. Tiffany Coburn has a music page. This is the way of the world now. Social media. And the great thing is, my mother is watching at home in Columbus, Georgia, along with thousands of other people who Cody can tell you've been streaming. I checked in on the stream a little while ago, and there was like 3,000 people on watching at that particular time. Now, you got to imagine, that's just not one person. That's like two or three or whoever it is. I'll just end with this. You know, when Tiffany talked about how these hymns, a lot of these hymns, I grew up in South Georgia, and I went to camp meeting, and these hymns are important and special to me. A lot of them are about escaping. It's almost like we can't wait to get to heaven. And I think that's great because it reminds us that this world is not our home and these loyalties of the world are not our home. But over the last couple of years, you know, American Christians, we got tied up in a lot of cultural stuff that really, really moved us, and we haven't behaved well with one another. And I'm just going to remind you that Jesus has got us here for a reason. And so it's great to look forward to our eternal home. But remember in Luke 6, that this morning, he said, whoever comes to me, hears my word, and then doesn't do anything else. Now, that's not what he says. He said, and acts on them. Put the words into practice. And when you look at Luke, you see he's talking about preaching to the poor, recovery of sight to the blind, release to the captives, let the oppressed go free, the year of the Lord's favor. Love those who hate you and persecute. Pray for your enemy. Someone asks you for something, you give it. They want your shirt, you give them your coat. That's what we're supposed to be about while we're here, is to build the house on the rock. And then I think of Horatio Spafford, they sung it as well. And he owned a lot of property in Chicago, lost all of his wealth in the Great Fire of 1871. He was going to England to support D.L. Moody on an evangelist trip, but he couldn't get away because he had to work on some of the stuff that he had lost. So he sent his family, his wife and his four daughters. Some of you know this story. And there was a shipwreck. His four daughters died. His wife lived, and she sent a telegram that said, saved, alone. And so he got on a boat, and he sailed to England, and when he passed the spot where the ship went down is where he wrote that song as well. Now, you think about building your house on a rock. Who's able to go through all of that and have that kind of faith? That's what we need, American Christians, Christians of the world. Is to not let politics and partisan and ideology and all that stuff derail us. We got to be the light of Christ for the world. Come to him, hear his words, and act on them. Thank you all for coming to Chapelwood tonight and being blessed by these amazing, amazing musicians. God bless.
Praise God from whom. Good night, Houston.